Hey guys, Aizenbaka here, and today we do episode 4 of Cold Can Ultimate, and let's get on with the video. I hear the unfamiliar sound of an alarm. An alarm clock is ringing, but whose is it? Knock it off already, alright? Just give me 5 more minutes. It? That sound is... Isn't that the new alarm clock I just bought? Why did I buy a new clock again? The dormitory! Oh crap! I just came here into room 204 of the Kashinomori Academy's boys' dormitory yesterday. Though, in spite of that, I was out like a light as soon as I hit my futon. That's right, this is going to be my new home, and I haven't even finished putting my luggage away yet. I quickly tapped the alarm button and shut it off. Having just woken up, Kaoru calls out my name with a sleepy voice. Sorry, did I wake you? That's right. Good morning. The dorm leader greeted us with some words of wisdom yesterday as we entered the dormitory. He said, as long as you're here, you'll be classmates, roommates, and rivals. Be aware of each other, help each other, compete with each other. That's how I want you to live in this dorm. Passionate words indeed, however... Kaoru stretches his arms, yawning without so much as a care in the world. Kaoru is as beautiful as any girl. Watching him yawn and seeing his hair still a disheveled mess aroused a strange mix of fear and excitement in me. Having to think of someone like that as a rival. Are you kidding me? Nothing. Forget about it. I quickly look away, embarrassed for some unfathomable reason. Let's change first and head to the cafeteria. Breakfast will probably be a while. Because we've only had the entrance ceremony and inspections yesterday, today is our first day of class. As we change our clothes, chow down on breakfast, and finally head to school, I feel my heart heavy with a mix of anxiety and anticipation. Beginning one's Doriku training starts off with getting used to the vessel you're assigned. In order to amplify its user's power, the vessel consolidates and controls the flow of Doriku. Once you've become accustomed to it, the strength of your Doriku will naturally increase. Jin shouts happily while brandishing his spear. Hey, that's dangerous! Quit showing off like that! Just as I'm distancing myself from Jin's reckless antics, I catch sight of Akane unsheathing her greatsword. You too? What are you going to do if you accidentally hurt someone? These guys are really something else, not that the others are much different. Even in this kind of adrenaline-pumping situation, Kamishiro's just standing around with the same bored expression as always. Is she still feeling dissatisfied about yesterday? Maybe she could use someone to hear her out. Just as I'm about to walk over, however, Akane's voice pulls me back.
Seiichi! Mirugai! Watashino Doryoku!
Brandishing her greatsword, Akane swings it down with might. A small fireball is released, but quickly disappears into the sky. Maybe it's just because the sword's so big, but that fireball sure seems small. Akane sighs. This is my chance to get away while she's distracted. With stealth-like steps, I slip away from Akane. Suddenly, it feels as though someone's grabbed a hold of my trousers. A shiver runs through me.
Seiichi?
So you did that on purpose?
いたずらとは聞こえの悪い。こいつは俺の訓練だぞ。寮長も言ってただろ。俺たちはクラスメートだが、同時にライバルだと。
Then don't go using your doryku on me like that.
はっはっは、もう一度食らいたいか。はあ。あ、
あ、あ、あ。Hey, what's wrong?
Doryku の使いすぎで立ちくらみが。
You need to rest a bit. While Jin struggles to catch his breath, a certain voice, tinged with anger, roars out.
こらこら！自分がしおれてどうするか、バカ者！
大丈夫です、師匠！これくらい気合でなんとか！
As Jin struggles to stand up, his strength suddenly gives out and he collapses.
保健員！このアホを邪魔にならないところへ連れて行け！
Jin quickly gets dragged away by the nurse for treatment.
ああ、兄貴ってばまたやってる。体調が悪いのに根性で動力を使うから。
Chata says this with an exasperated voice, briskly making her way over to him with a wilted flower in hand. It must be frustrating with his condition always like that.
まあね。でも、僕からしたら慣れたもんだよ。
Chata laments while stroking the wilted flower. Amazingly, the flower that was wilted just a moment ago regains its flawless beauty as if it had just bloomed. Wow! So that's your ability, huh?
So, じゃあこの力でバカ兄貴のこともちょっと回復してくるよ。じゃあね。
Chata jokes as she makes her way over to where Jin is. Now then, Kamishiro.With some time to myself at last, I look towards Kamishiro again. Kamishiro's still standing in the same place she was before. I hear Kamishiro mutter in a small voice. While she's doing so, however, she's lightly swinging her sword around. Whoa! Despite the fact that she isn't moving around much,The air around the tip of her sword is frighteningly cold. Footpaths, trees, and everything else in its path are frozen in a beautiful sheen of pure white. Though Fujishima-sensei seems pleased, everyone else is just sitting around idly. Really, even though it looks like she's not doing much, Kamishiro's Doryku powers are amazingly high.
すごいな、Doryku!
Still frustrated over her consistently small flame, Akane hurries over to Toko.
別に普通か。
よし、私も。
Her enthusiasm rising, Akane swings her sword at the tree frozen by Kamishiro. A fireball appears in the air and slowly drifts towards the frozen tree like a soap bubble. As soon as it makes contact though,It fizzles out and disappears.
こういう場合、焼け石に水とは言わないか。
そもそも基本の能力値が違いすぎね。
無駄だってわからないのかしら。
もっとだ、トゥーリア
ー。ねえ、靖国さん、もうやめたら。
あなたは確か港と言ったか。昨日の昼休み、太田と一緒にいたな。
ええ、彼とは古くから知り合いなの。はじめまして、靖国さん。
ああ、はじめまして、港。それで、なぜやめなくてはならないのだ。これは鍛錬だ。ならば、全力を尽くすのが道理なはず。
分かってないみたいね。あなた今、自分の仮面に泥を塗っているのよ。
Disgrace? That's a little harsh, don't you think?
Yeah. いいのだ、セイチ。
Akane placed a hand on my shoulder, holding me back before I could say any more.
みなと。そうか。もしやと思っていたが、今の言葉で確信した。あなたは、みなと家のものか。
ええ、そうよ。
なるほど。だから昨日の適正判断でも、動力機の扱いに慣れていたのだ。合点が言った。
I didn't bother checking anybody else out, but it looks like Akane did. Now I'm a little bit intrigued that Akane, who, unlike myself, was dutifully assessing her peers. Hmm? What's the Minato house?
Ah, 彼女の家も我が靖国家と同様、琴名討伐において大きな功績を残した一族なんだ。
もっとも、うちには靖国家のような政権もないし、知名度も一段下だけどね。
So she says with a cold tone, ripe with sarcasm. Still, Minato's from a distinguished family of Doryuku users too. In other words, she's another elite among the elite.
動力使いは家柄だけでなく実力がものを言うからな。知名度なら飾りに過ぎない。現にこの私が政権の一つは使いこなせていない。
そうみたいね。だから忠告しているのがわからないのかしら。まあせいぜい好きにするといいわ。
After saying that, Minato left. She's a cool beauty type, almost like Kamishiro.
大場は今私の顔を見て失礼なことを思ってる。
No, it's not rude, butKamishiro's glance is strangely sharp.
Yasukuni は Yasukuni の考えであればいい。気にする必要はない。
ありがとう、トーコ。何？あれくらいのこと、言われ慣れてる。そう簡単に、私の思いは燃え尽きないぞ！
Akane wasn't going to let herself be discouraged by slander like that. In order to melt Kamishiro's eyes, she grabbed her vessel once more.Do your best, Akane. With a weak power like that though, melting that ice could be difficult, to say the least. But as long as she holds onto that spirit of hers, she might be able to do it someday. Anyway, I should be worrying about myself first. Taking a look at the normal sword in my hand, I can't help but sigh. Apparently, this serves as the foundation for a Doryuku vessel, but right now it's no better than a normal sword. But,If what everyone else is using could be likened to be a bicycle, then this is a tricycle. It's something that'll help imprint the basic of basics, simple and low quality. Even though it's so simple, I haven't mastered it yet. A vast pool of Doryuku power is stored in my body, which was found during the Doryuku measuring test. Just how am I supposed to bring it out?It's said that a Doryuku user is able to understand their power's nature all on their own, but I can't seem to grasp it at all.
何をぼーっとしとるのだ、オーバ
ー。 I'm not daydreaming. I'm just stuck because I can't figure out how to use this thing.
同じだろうが、バカ者。
Ouch!
動力が使えないのなら、とりあえず素振りでもしていろ。
But practice swings, huh?
動力器を体に馴染ませるには、やはり素振りが一番効果的だからな。
You say it's effective, but will I really be able to use Doryuku this way? Though I felt like I just said something ridiculous, Fujishima-sensei doesn't appear angry at all. Instead, she just patiently explains to me.
動力を貯水タンクの水に例えて考えろ。動力器は水を使うための蛇口だとしよう。
Tank and...Faucet?
ここにいるみんなは貯水タンクと動力器をつなぐパイプを持っているわけだ。蛇口をひねれば水が出るし、ひねる大きさで水の量が変わる。
Indeed, it's an easy to understand analogy.
貴様の場合は貯水タンクどころかダム並みの大きさを持っている。
Analogy wise, it should be like that.
ね、ここに蛇口がある。
Fujishima-sensei places her hand on mine, the one that holds my sword. She's forceful, and the palm of her hand is hot. It's almost like Sensei's confidence and passion is flowing directly into me. So, the pipe. So, if that's the case, what should I do? Though I have my doubts, Fujishima-sensei replies promptly. What? You don't know? There's a lot more I want to ask, but Fujishima-sensei's gaze just keeps wandering around.
パイプが太いもの、細いもの、蛇口のコントロールがうまいもの、下手なもの。そして、その水が毒になったり薬になったりと、ここには様々なものが集まっているが、貴様のようなタイプは過去に一人も入学していない。Well,
I can understand that.
膨大な水で潤ったダムを背負っているくせに、渇水しているも同然だからな。
That's a cruel way to put it, but I think she's right. How should I start?
まずは素振りだ。
Fujishima-sensei repeated that clearly.
貴様が動力が使えないわけが判明し、使えるようになる方法が判明する日がいつか来る。いいか、絶対に。だ。その時、貴様自身も貴様の持つ膨大な動力に耐えきれない。そんなことがないとは言え。だからそうならないように、常日頃から備えておくのだ。
Right. So I've got no choice but to wait for now. All I can do is train for that day.
その通りだ。もう一つ貴様に忠告しておく。
Yes, what is it?
決して諦めるな。それだけ。After
that simple but powerful message, Fujishima-sensei walks off towards the other students. Never give up. Got it. I turn back my attention towards Akane.
まだまだ!
Akane is still giving her all to try and melt the ice that Kamishiro made. It looks like she really won't give up. Excluding me, Akane is obviously the weakest Doriku user in the S-Class. Yet, in spite of that, Akane keeps up her training without the slightest thought of giving up. She works harder than anyone else. Alright, time to start my training. With Fujishima-sensei's words ringing in my head, and Akane's feeling burning in my heart, I feel a lot more determined. I'll be counting on you, partner! As I talk to the sword, I begin my practice swings with a renewed determination.
ただの剣を持って、ただの素振りだなんて、トライエスの動力使いがすることとは、到底思えないな。Huh?
Hearing Ota's voice, I quickly turn around to see him standing there. Being able to use a sword well is important for our training too.
君は本当にそんなことをしていていいのか?
Ota said to me, his eyes concealing a bit of suspicion. What do you mean?
力を発動させられるようになろうとは思わない。
I think, for the moment, I should follow Fujishima-sensei's advice and practice swinging my sword. Not to mention this is the best I can do right now. I guess from Ota's perspective, what I'm doing now must seem really low level. But I am seriously working to bring out my own Doryuku.
C クラスでもっと専門的に動力について学んでみるとか、どこかの研究機関にトライエスであることを売り込んでみるとかあるだろう。Yeah,
I could. What Ota is saying, I can't say it never crossed my mind. But still, I want to work hard here in this S class. I definitely don't want to wind up as someone's guinea pig in a laboratory somewhere.
すまん、少しきつく言い過ぎた。 でも勘違いしないで。別に大場のことを責めてるわけじゃないんだ。
I thought I was being criticized, but it looks like that might not have been so.
俺は俺自身が恥ずかしいんだ。動力を使えないものを自分の目標なんかにしてしまう。
That's my fault. I should have told you earlier that I can't use my Doriku. I also apologize to Ota. It doesn't matter that Ota misunderstood the situation on his own. It's difficult for me to say that I wasn't at fault as well. However, Ota doesn't say anything. Rather, he just stands there and stares at me quietly. Ota?
謝るくらいなら、大場はちゃんと動力を発動させてくれよ。
Right.
俺が大場に望むのは謝罪の言葉でも言い訳でもない。動力を発動させることだ。それまで俺は決して君を認めないからな。
It was a declaration of war. Ota's that kind of guy. One who desires an honest rivalry, stripped of any notion of optimism or forgiveness. He's an extremely prideful and honest man.
それだけだ。練習邪魔したな。
After Ota says that, as he walks away, I'm not going to give up just because things aren't going my way. I'm absolutely going to awaken my Doriku. After that encounter with Ota, I feel my fighting spirit burning like magma.
リアルからしてこの式の回は。
After Doriku training, we are back to our usual classes. Trying to withhold my yawn, I stare at the blackboard. After moving around so much earlier, my whole body feels like lead ready to drop off at a moment's notice.
そうだな。仮眠しろ。解いてみろ。
はい。X の事情マイナス Y の4乗分の Z の3乗プラス1。
正解。よし、続いて次の設問に移る。
Wow! So she's good at this stuff too.
うん、上白さんってどの教科も強いよね。
Right.
僕は家庭科なら自信があるんだけど、お裁縫とか。
Aw, Kaoru, you're gonna make a good wife someday. I don't think they have anything like that here. The expectations are a lot tougher than I thought, though.
僕もちんぷんかんぷん。特に理系は強烈に難しいよね。
All these formulas are making my head spin. This really is an elite school, isn't it?
ほら、オーバー!無駄話をしている暇があったら、この回を答えてみろ。
Damn! Looks like I've been spotted. Just looking at that wall of text on the blackboard makes me want to faint. It's way beyond anything that I studied for the entrance exam. My drowsiness isn't helping either. Most of the lecture has gone in one ear and out of the other. I don't know, sir.
なんだ、オーバー。お前は動力値だけで入学したのか？
その動力も使えないんだから、何しに来てるんだか。
Ota's words quickly brings an uproar of laughter from the class.
おい、今は授業中だろ？つまらないチャチャを入れるなよ。
先生、続きをどうぞ。
すまんな、オーバー。私も口が過ぎた。では、次の設問に移る。
With Jin and Chiara's help, class resumes as usual. I can't just continue to take something like that lying down next time. Akane quietly slips me a folded piece of paper. As I open it, I see beautifully worded handwriting that says, Let's do our best. As my eyes trail across the paper,It's almost like I can hear Akane's cheerful voice. Thanks, Akane. As two people who had been looked down upon and even made fun of, we resolved to do our best without giving up. After slipping the paper into my pencil case, I shake off my drowsiness and concentrate on the class. As the class continues well into the evening, we're totally exhausted by the time we finally get back to the dorms.
疲れた。自分の訓練だけじゃなくて、兄貴の治療にも動力を使って、
많이 疲れたよ.
Chara grumbles while walking, but out of nowhere, her back straightens.
あ、あれ、ゆずちゃんだ。おーい、ゆずちゃん。
あ、千春さん。それに、誠一さんたちも。
Hey, Yuzu, you're still plenty energetic.
はい。授業が始まったばかりで、まだほとんど何もしてませんからね。
そうなのか？こっちは今日から猛訓練で、ヘトヘトだというのに。
そうなんですか？
Yeah, all those practice swings really did a number on my arms.
ゆずちゃん、僕疲れ果てちゃって歩くのも大変なの。部屋まで連れてって。
Overzealous to a near fault, Chiara leans over and clings onto Yuzu.
あの、Chiara さん。
The surprised Yuzu lets out a small laugh.
もう、あんまりふざけないでくださいよ。ほら、行きますよ。
はーい。じゃあ、兄貴たち、また夕食の時にね。それじゃ、部屋に行こうか、ゆずちゃん。
わかりましたから。くっついたままじゃ歩きにくいですよ。
いいの。僕にとってはこの方が歩きやすいんだよ。
ゆず smiles, as if conceding her defeat. Chara clings on tight as they head off to the woman's dorm.
ゆずちゃん、無事だといいんだけどな。
Jin mutters.What do you mean? Don't tell me Yuzu's body is in danger, in regards to her chastity mainly.
いや、大丈夫だ。ああ見えて妹にも常識はあるからな。多分。
Jin, why did you hesitate when you say probably? Don't say that with your head turned away. Please make sure she's safe, okay? But then again, Yuzu always looks pretty happy with Chiara. I'm sure that everything's fine.
ヤスクに、私たちも。
あ、そうだな。うん。
Trying to hide her exhaustion, Akane heads over to the woman's dorm.
では、またな。
Okay, go work today.
別に、疲れていない。
I thought you'd say something like that, Kamishiro. Akane looks totally wiped out, but Kamishiro looks the same as always.Not a hint of fatigue or exhaustion about her. The two polar opposites walk towards the woman's dorm to catch up to Yuzu and Chara.
僕たちも帰ろうか。
そうだな。飯の前に一風呂浴びたいとこだけど、時間おるかね。
We really won't have time if we just stand here talking. So let's go back to the dorm for now. With that, we head off and return to the men's dorm together.
みんなで食べる食事は本当に美味しいな。
After the meal, Akane sips tea with a pleased look. I thought that dorm food would taste a lot worse than this.
本当に美味しくてびっくりしました。
いやー、うちのママンが作った料理より全然いけてる。
ああ、ママンに言いつけよう。
うちのママンの料理は最高だよ。
ジンくんってお母さんが怖いんだ。
ここの料理が美味しいのは本当。
学生の健康面や精神面を気遣っているんだな。さすがは樫の森学園。食事一つでも気合が入るというものだ。
By the way, did you have something like training, Yuzu?I asked, recalling what Yuzu had said earlier.
はい。動力理論の基礎的なことをおさらいして。誠一さんたちは違うんですか?
Yeah, it was really intense. You can tell from how exhausted we all are.
確かに、疲れ果てた顔ですね。
結局、一日がかりでも。倉庫の氷を溶かすことはできなかった。うん。まだまだ修行が足りない。
俺も誰かを10秒止めたら1分ぶっ倒れるようじゃ使い物にならないからな。まずは基礎体力だな。
そういえばみんな、動力器をしまえるようにはなった？
When Kata asked that, Jin and Chara both nod at the same time.
ああ、槍を振り回してたら、なんとなくこうやればいいかなって感覚が頭に浮かんできてな。
うんうん。気がついたら、無意識にしまえるようになってたんだよね。
出すのも簡単だぜ。今ここで出してやろうか。
Don't even think about it. You can't be swinging your huge spear around the dining hall. At the same time, I'm secretly hoping that no one will ask me the same question. My normal sword is just sheathed at my waist. As Yuzu says that, she brings out her own Doryuku vessel for us to see. It looks like a staff with a blade attached to it.
Yuzu の動力器は杖なのか?
Yuzu awkwardly holds a strange staff in her hand.
研究者用の杖なんですけど、しまえないととっても邪魔なんですよ。でも持ってないといけないし。
確かに、研究職なのに僕の剣よりもかっこいいなんて。特別な事情でもなければ、こちらから選ぶことはできないのだ。仕方ないだろう。
Says the person who's in one of those special circumstances.
C クラスじゃまだ本格的な研究はやってないんだろう。じゃあ、これからだな。
はい、楽しみです。
Though the meal has ended, the dining room is still very noisy.It isn't just at us though, all the female freshmen at their respective tables are abuzz with talk about their exciting new lives. This continues until the dorm leader comes out and scolds us to go back to our rooms. However, our seniors including the dorm leader evict us, but instead of returning to the men's dorm, we find ourselves led to the rear of the dorm. What's going on?
ヘトヘトだし、帰って寝てんだけどな。
あ、寮長さんが何か話すみたい。
というわけで、これから毎年恒例の新入生への試練を与える。
試練?燃えるな。どんな内容なんですか?
Jin, I thought you were tired. Stop lying. As soon as Jin hears the word trial, he plays right into their hands like a moth to a flame.
あんまりハードなのは困るんですけど、ちゃんとバックして早寝しないとお肌が荒れちゃうし。
Seeing him frowning cutely, I can't help but think, is he really a guy?
はっはは、安心しろ。このミッションは我が家リビド満載なお前たちにとっても悪くない話だぞ。
Useful libido. What's this trial got to do with that?I'm starting to have a bad feeling about this.
よくぞ聞いてくれた。お前たちに与える試練、それは。
女子寮に侵入してその中を覗き、一人前の男になってこい!
Man, I would love to do that. You want us to peep on the girls?
ええ?マジですか?
It isn't just Jin.A lot of the other boys are vocal too.
先輩、それはお風呂を含めてという意味でしょうか?
A classmate raises his hand with a serious face and says something unbelievable. Hold on. Isn't this a crime? We could get in serious trouble for this.
無論、風呂を含めてだ。
I can hear the freshmen really getting fired up about this.
無理無理、そんなの絶対無理だよ。
Kata covers his bright red face with both hands.
シー、大声を上げると女子寮に聞こえるだろう。これは新入生恒例の行事なのだ。拒否は許さん。
先輩として最後に一つだけアドバイスだ。普通の覗きと思ったらその時点で負けだ。 これはサバイバルだということを忘れるな。
了解であります。
After handing over the map with recommended locations for peeping, the seniors give a thumbs up and leave. After the seniors leave, I look over to my companions.
どうする?サバイバルだと思って取り組むべきか?
No matter how much you think about it, a peeping Tom is still a peeping Tom.
女の子のお風呂を見るなんて、そんなエッチなことできないよ。
何を言うんだ。憧れのこのお風呂シーンが見られたら、我が青春に一片の悔いなしだろう。
そうだな。正直、この学園の女子たちは当たり揃いだと思っていたんだが、はっきり言って、興味は、ある。
Everyone's full of useless motivations.
いいか、2000から行動開始だ。
お
ー While everyone keeps their voices low, they raise their fist in unison. Somehow this turned into one amazing show of unity.
バカバカしい。
Disgusted by the rest of the crowd, Ota alone returns to his room. We set out for a point where we can walk through the street at night and peek over at the women's dormitory. All the motivated ones go first and we follow soon after. Hey guys, maybe we shouldn't go through with this after all. It's a useless effort on my part, but I'm hoping that I can at least persuade Jin.
Yeah.俺も正直、どうかとは思ってるんだが。でも、先輩たちが、これはサバイバルだって言ってただろ?そこから逃げるのは、男らしくないと思う。
Well, that's true, Jin. But remember, your sister is a part of that dorm. And if you see your sister naked, you're gonna become a Siscon. And we can't have that. It's an obvious excuse. Jin's face is lit with a bright expression. No, if it's about survival, there are plenty of moral alternatives. Even if it's a direct order from the seniors, I don't know about doing something we might regret later.
みんなパラダイスがあるって言ってるけど、僕は早くお布団に入りたいよ。
柴崎、布団に入るのは鑑賞が終わってからだ。
Everyone else nods too. Their eyes are full of desire, almost bloodthirsty. We're already inside the women's dormitory. It's probably too late to retreat now. It might be a good idea to just get this over with and get out of here. As everyone proceeds along quietly, we finally arrive at the spot the seniors told us about. From the other side of the wall, the sound of running water and girls' voices can be heard.Can't blame him for being nervous. Shh! They'll hear us! I raise my finger to my lips and try and quiet them. Since we're already here, I don't want to get found out.
Seiji, ここまで来たら、覚悟を決めようぜ。
No, I haven't prepared myself for that. Either I'm labeled a pervert, I die, or I go to jail. But no, I did not prepare myself for that.Jin whispers to me in a small voice. Everyone else nods in agreement.
先輩、壁に小さな穴があって、そこから覗けるって言ってたよね。ここかな?
Kata points to a tiny hole that he discovered in the wall. I certainly didn't expect that we'd be able to peep from outside. For a person who didn't like the idea, he sure is quick to notice it.
なるほど。ここが先輩の言うパラダイス地点か。
The air is so thick with tension that you can practically taste it.
出た。誰から行く?
そういえば決めてなかったな。じゃんけんでもするか。
バカ!こんなところでじゃんけんなんかして騒いだら見つかっちまうぞ!だからでもいい。早くやるんだ!
そうだな。とにかく、一番近いやつからでいい。
The closest guy? Isn't that Kaoru?
そうだね。一番近くにいる人からでいいよ。
Huh? Kaoru's voice. Why is it behind me? As I turn around, I find that Kaoru has managed to slip behind me. It?
一番 近い やつ ってことは、聖一からだな。
Huh? In a panic, I quickly look around. For some reason, I find myself in the front row. No way! Still confused, I feel Jin pushing me from behind.
いいから早くしろって！後ろまで順番が回らないだろ？
Hey, hold up! As my back is pushed, my face smashes up against the wall, and my eye is pressed against the hole.
寮の風呂というのも、思ったよりも広くて快適だな。
Wow. Literally the best scene I have seen of today. 10 out of 10. The first voice I hear is all too familiar.
体が伸ばせるから、ストレッチもしやすいぞ。
Akane soaks herself in the bathtub as she raises her arms up high. Her voluptuous breasts sway back and forth in the hot water. Oh, this is bad. I shouldn't look any more than this. But I can't take my eyes off. The pink bud is at the tip of the bulge, though it's hard to see because of the steam.
I hate this steam.
本当に気持ちいいな。瞳子たちも早く湯船に浸かるといいぞ。
洗い終わったら。
I hear a cool, subtle voice across from Akane. This voice is...
安国は洗うのが早すぎる。
そんなことはない。ちゃんと洗ってから湯船に入ったぞ。
Looking over in the direction of the voice, I see Toko and Yuzu washing their bodies next to each other.
Toko-san って肌がすっごく綺麗ですね。その美肌の秘訣って何ですか？
何もしてない。
そうなんですか？いいなぁ。何もしないでこんなにすべすべのお肌だなんて。
Don't belittle yourself, Yuzu.Your beautiful skin definitely won't lose to Kamishiro's.
Yuzu-chan だって負けてないって。ほら、こんなにお肌プリプリ。
As if our thoughts are aligned, Chiara quickly dashes in and clings to Yuzu.
ほら、きれいきれいしましょうね。一人でできます。
Yuzu.Please don't make those sounds. It's way too erotic. Chiara runs her bubble-covered hands all over the ticklish Yuzu's body. I'm so jealous. No, I'm absolutely enraged.
お風呂は最高だね。極楽極楽。助けてくださいよ。
無理。
As Yuzu is groped by Chiara, Kamishiro declares her intent coldly as she turns around and washes her body. Wait, she's turning around? Oh, how regrettable. If only the bathrooms weren't so filled with steam. However, I can see it clearly with my own eyes. Even with the steam, I can clearly make out Kamishiro's slim figure.This figure will surely remain burned into my memory.
Seiichi-kun, どう? 見えちゃってるの?
Oh, Kaoru, you have no idea. I can see everything. Amazing. What a sight. I can see it all. Stunned at my words, everyone behind me starts making a fuss.
Awa, awa. Goshi, goshi.
Whoa, there's even an underage girl there too. Even though I can see her clearly, it unfortunately doesn't please me at all.
So-ka! じゃあ次は俺が!
I hear Jin collapse. Jin, you okay? you didn't freak out and faint, did you? However, just as I'm about to look back...
しかし、聖一はなかなか見どころのあるやつだな。
Hearing my name, I instinctively pressed my eyes against the hole again.
好きになった?
いや、そういう浮ついた話でなく、同じ志を持つ者としてだ。
でも、茜さん、顔が真っ赤ですよ。
Finally free from Chiharu, Yuzu asks Akane.
Mataku Yuzu made. Kore wa sukoshi yu ni nobosetta dake da.
Eh? Am I hearing things right? I feel like I'm peeping on something even more risquez than their naked bodies. The contents of the conversation has piqued my interest so much that I can't look away or stop listening.
Demo, Akane-san no kimochi mo wakaru kamo desu.
ゆずちゃん、わかっちゃうんだ。
久しぶりに会った聖一さんは、相変わらずに優しくて、でも、子供の時よりも、身長とか伸びて、男らしくなってて。
昔のことはわからないけれど、精神力があるのは事実。
そうかもね。じゃないと、動力が使えないのに、貸し登りに来ようなんて思わないよね。
だから私は、聖一は大した奴だと思うのだ。決して、それ以上の意味ではなく。
早く、おい、オーバー、早くしろ。
Even though they're poking at my back, I'm too anxious to leave.
Hold up, it's just getting good.
The girl talk on the other side of the wall has only just begun to blossom.
そういえば、ユズは、聖一のことが好きなのか?
それはその、小さい時は好きだったかもしれませんけど、男女の好きかどうかは、まだわからないです。
まあ、子供の頃とはそういうものかもしれないな。
じゃあさ、幼馴染ってことは、一緒にお風呂に入った経験があるとか?
はい、子供の頃の話ですけれど。
ってことは、聖一くんのあれ、見たことあるんだ。
え?あれって?やだ!知りません!
恥ずかしそうに語るユズちゃん、最高!
Come to think of it, I did bathe with Yuzu a lot when we were kids.Right now, if Yuzu were to take a bath with me, it definitely wouldn't be like those innocent childhood days, that's for sure.
やばいよ、聖一くん!やばいんだって!
Ah, Kaoru! Yeah, this is dangerous! Amazingly dangerous! I nod without looking back.
なあ、こういうことはやっぱり良くないと思うんだ。
そうそう。やっぱ清く正しく生きないと。ってわけで、俺たちは先に戻るから。
It sounds like someone's walking away. Certainly, I might be taking too long. Let's change soon. Kaoru, are you next? While saying that, I beckon to Kaoru behind me as I say that. My hands touches something soft. Is it Kaoru's body? Strange.Is a man's body usually this soft? No offense, Kaoru, but I think your stomach could use some work.
Oba! 貴様の度胸の良さには感心するぞ!
That's not good. Looking back to where I hear the piercing voice, I see Fujishima-sensei standing there. I mean, only Fujishima-sensei is there.Everyone else who came with me is nowhere to be seen. Those guys. They abandoned me and escaped? Still clinging to the wall, I curse my fellow classmates in my mind.
覗きだけでは飽き足らず、女教師に対する痴漢行為か。一見おとなしそうに見えてなかなか大胆だな。
My eyes immediately shift to my outstretched hand. The soft object I thought was Kaoru's belly was actually Fujishima-sensei's breast. No, this is a misunderstanding. I didn't mean to.
Ho. では女子ブルの覗きが目当てだったということか。
Ah, well, that's right. I did come to peep, but touching Sensei's chest was definitely an accident. Lying would only make things worse, so I confessed honestly.
毎年女子寮を覗きに来るバカどもは後を絶たないが、まさか動力が使えない大場が来るとはな。
She tapped my shoulder. Why do I feel my body getting hotter?
しかも貴様一人でやってくるとは、大した度胸じゃない。
No, I didn't come alone, but...
他の連中は見回りの気配をさして、特に見ない。
Traitors!
逃げずに堂々と一人で覗きを続けた。その度胸の良さだけは認めてやる。
Sensei laughs, almost as if she were impressed. At least she doesn't seem to be angry. Excuse me, but... Aren't you angry?
その必要はないから。生還したければそれなりに頑張ることだな。
Fujishima sensei gives me a broad grin, urging me to look behind me. In one piece, I turn around slowly. An enormous wall of ice suddenly appears. What? Touching the wall in surprise, I feel a strong electric current shock me. Gah! Damn, is this the Doriku trap I heard about?This is a home for Doriku users after all, so it should be security that acts accordingly. When certain conditions are met, the charged Doriku is triggered and unleashed just like now. It looks like the condition for this trap is peeping. Ah damn! You gotta be kidding me! Flame surges up and blocks off my escape route. Even though I look around for help, there's no one else here but me. Someone! There's gotta be someone left here! It looks like someone managed to drag Jin away even though he was passed out. If I don't get away somehow. The ice wall is way too thick, but it's blocking my only escape route. And the flame and electric attacks are coming at me without mercy. Ah! Bombarded with from all sides by rounds of flame and electricity, I feel my consciousness beginning to fade.
罠に引っかかったクセモノはこっちか。
で、聖一ではないか。
アカネ。アカネ、sword in hand, shouts out as she sees me in tatters. Not only アカネ, but everyone else had taken up behind her and drawn their Doriku vessels as well.
大場が覗き魔。
Kamishiro's normally cold eyes become even colder. No, I'm.Senpai said this was just a...
言い訳とは、見苦しいぞ、聖一。
聖一さん、信じていたのに、変なところでたくましくなっちゃうなんて、悲しいです。
Yuzu, please don't look at me like that.
覗きなんて許さないよ。美少女鑑賞は、同じ女である僕の特権なんだからね。
お嫁に行けないよ。
大爆って最低。けだものだわ。
While the girls abuse me with harsh words, they slowly approach. Their anger flaring, the vessels in their hands shine radiantly. Wait, can we talk this through?
覗かなければトラップは発動しない。
トーコの言う通りだ。くらえ。
Akane brandishes her greatsword, and the other girls prepare to attack me all at once.
ちゃんと責任取ってよね、大場くん。
Yeah! The last thing I see before I pass out is the clear, beautiful night sky. Vessel after vessel raining down their respective judgment on my body like divine thunder.Like divine thunder, as it said, But we are very close to the 1 hour mark, so I think this is a good place to stop this episode of Kouken Otome. I hope you guys enjoyed this wonderful episode with oppais and boobs and bath and peeping, all that stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Like, comment, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Eisenbaka, signing out.